The lamb that was slain, he's alive. Forever he shall reign, he's alive. They crucified at Calvary, but he rose in victory. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive with all power in his hands. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive with all power in his hands. The lamb that was slain, he's alive. Forever he shall reign. He's alive. They crucified a Calvary, but he rose in victory. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive with all power in his hand. He's alive. He's alive. The lamb that was slain, he's alive. Forever he shall reign, he's alive. They crucified at Calvary, but he rose in victory. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive. We're all power. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive with all power in his hands. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive with all power in his hands. He's alive. He's alive. Authority, he conquered my enemies, he put them under my feet. He rose in glory with all power and authority. He conquered my enemies, he put them under my feet. Come on, say, he rose in glory with all power and authority. He conquered my enemies. He put them under my feet. He rose in glory with all power and authority. He conquered my enemies. He put them under my feet.
One more time.
He rose in glory with all power and authority. He conquered my enemies. He put them under my feet.
He's alive.
He's alive. He's alive. He's alive. With all power in his hands. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive. With all power in his hands.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a wonderful thing to know that God, Jesus, rose with all power in his name. Good morning to all of you this morning. We are here for another homecoming celebration. And let us go to God in prayer. Let us quiet our hearts before the Lord. Father, we honor you this morning. We glorify your matchless name. You are the God of all glory, the God of all power. And you have allowed us, oh God, to be here one more time, oh God, to worship your name, to lift up the name of Jesus, to celebrate together for all that you have done for us over these many years. Thank you, oh God, for waking us up this morning. Thank you, God, for bringing all of these people from all the places they have come in with safety, oh God, to your house to worship you. We thank you, oh God. And first of all, Lord, we ask you to forgive us for anything at all that is inside of us that we have done or not done that is not of you, oh God. We ask you for your forgiveness. And we lift your name, oh God, and ask you to take the glory for everything that will be said and done in this house today. We thank you for the musicians. We thank you, oh God, for the man of God who is going to bring forth your word with power and with clarity. And so, God, we just ask you now to open up our hearts, oh Lord God, so that we may receive this word that you have given him to feed us this morning. And so, Lord, we thank you. We praise your name. We ask you to take preeminence in this house, oh God, in our hearts, in our lives, by your Holy Spirit. And we will be careful, oh God, to give you all the glory for everything that will be said and done in this house today. We will not forget, oh God, those who are not able to be here with us today. And we ask, oh God, for your covering, for your protection, for your hand upon them. Those who are grieving, oh God, we ask you for your continued grace upon them, oh God, so that they will be comforted. Lord, take over now. Reign and rule and come and tabernacle with us, because we ask all of this in the precious and all-powerful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And we say thank you for hearing and answering prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
You, Lord, oh, thank you. You, Lord, oh, just want to thank you, Lord. Can everybody lift their voice this morning and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Selection. Sovereign, all elders, sovereign God, we remember our elders of African descent. They fought courageously during times of war and peace. They built much of the United States of America with the knowledge, skill, and sweat of their brows. They also built their own institutions when denied admissions to the institutions of others. They care for their own needs and the needs of others. Despite many hardships, they sustain their families and communities. They loved God. They created new means of expressing that love in their preaching and praying, in their spirituals and gospel music. They built churches and religious organizations and expressed their faith in the lives they lived. They gave us birth. They loved and cared for us. They passed a cherished heritage on to us. Our elders educated us and open our eyes to the beauty of our past and the hopefulness of our future. They taught us to love ourselves and one another.
We remember our elders today with love and gratitude.
They filled their lives with art, poetry, and literature. They excelled whenever they were given the opportunity. They were brilliant, creative, and inventive. They painted, tapped, sculpted, drummed, hummed, sang, and shouted, leaving us a rich, imaginative legacy. Now let us call the names of some of them. Absalom Jones, Lemuel Hayes, Richard Allen, David Walker, Maria Stewart, Sojourner Truth, and Jarena Lee.
Daniel Payne, Bridget Douglas, Mary Pleasant, Harriet Tubman, Nanny Hale Burroughs, and Rupert T. Washington.
Anna Julia Cooper, William O. Tanner, Ida B. Wells, Mary Church Terrell, George Washington Carver, Adam Clayton Powell, and William E. B. Du Bois. Now let us be mindful of those elders whose names are lost to us in history. Those who were washed away in the Middle Passage, let us remember them before God. Let us now call the names of elders, living and departed, who in our lifetime have positively influenced our homes, churches, communities, and the world. You can speak names out silently, out loud if you like.
Say, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. It tells me of a Savior's love, who died to set me free. It tells me of his precious blood, the sinner's perfect plea. Everybody say, oh, how I love Jesus. Sing it, no. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me. Can we say it again? Say, oh, how I love Jesus. Wave your hand and say, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me.
I gotta say it one more time. Say, oh, how I love Jesus. Everybody say, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me.
Beautiful song. Thank you so much. We'll now have our welcome by Miss Mary Mackley. Thank you so much. That's all right. As one of the homecomers, I'd like to say thank you so much for the welcome. I appreciate it so much and the hospitality that has been shown this weekend to members of the church, to visitors, and to us, the homecomers. Actually, as I think of Antioch, of course, I grew up in this church, as many of you know, and I'm wearing my hat today because when I grew up in this church, on homecoming Sunday, regardless of the weather outside, which now I realize was very warm, as it was always third Sunday in August, the ladies of the church wore their new fall hat for homecoming Sunday. So in honor of our elders, those who have come before us, I wear this hat today in honor of them. Okay. And now for responses from our other homecomers. Please limit your remarks to 2 minutes. I would like to say, if possible, and if you are a member of Antioch or were a former member of Antioch, please give us the names of elders who you would like for us to remember today and their impact upon you and homecoming services in this church. Thank you. Don't all speak at once. I'll recognize you. Thank you. I know you're raring to go. Should I call on homecomers? Wait, let me put my glasses on. Okay, who's first? Yes, ma'am. Good morning.
Its pastor, with its officers, and with its members. You are a blessing to this community. I pray that you continue in your worship and in doing the things that God wants you to do. Amen.
Good morning. I do not need the mic. I have to teach you. Okay. I just want to say it is always a pleasure to come home. Home is a place that you can leave and you can come back to at any time. And that has never changed here. Home is a little different when we come back now because some people are not here.
That's right.
But this Antioch, this place, is the same. It has remained constant. The people are the same. The warm and friendly smiles and the feeling that we get when we come. It's always amazing, and I speak of it often. I bring you greetings from First Baptist Church, South Hill, in Chesapeake, Virginia. My pastor is Reverend Michael R. Tolliver, and it's just a blessing to be here to celebrate with Mom and the rest of the family and to see everyone here. Thank you. Amen. Need the mic.
Okay.
While the next person is waiting to stand, I'm ready to recognize you. But I would be remiss if I didn't mention the names of Gladys White and Alice Jackson. They were members of our gospel chorus here, and it was very popular. I love the gospel music. I think it started with the music from that chorus. Also, Celestine Jackson, my mother, she was the president of the usher board for over 30 years. And so there's a rich history of our family here in the church. Brenda Tompkins, thank you.
Good morning. In honor of my family, I just want to say I'm very happy to be here this morning. And I didn't want to miss homecoming. So just pray for me. Just pray for me, please. Mm-hmm.
Hello, Antioch. So glad to be here one more time. I call it all the time good old Antioch. I love this place. And I'm so glad to be here today. I sit down home every day, look at the window door, and everyone was, I think, for Antioch. And I thought to myself, I said, wish I were at Antioch today. So I'm so glad I was able to get you there. I don't know what to do. And I've been so happy in my life. Thank you for being here.
Is it anybody else? They're recording, so we need to speak into the mic.
I need it anyway. My voice is very weak.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Esther White. This is my church. This is my church, and I love it. But now I'm in Richmond, Virginia. We reside in Richmond, Virginia, where we are members of Fifth Baptist Church, where the Doctors Earl M. and Ricardo Brown are pastors. But I will say on this homecoming, I've heard a lot of good things. I want to remember, I could remember a lot of people, but you've covered a lot of them. But this morning I'll represent my grandmother, Rose Ella Wiggins, who was a very quiet lady, but she, Miss Gladys, and some others would get together, get ready for homecoming, and they would start talking about their dress and everything. And my grandmother Rosella wasn't on time all the time, but homecoming Sunday, she got her seat so she could see all of the homecomers. And then I go to my grandmother, Emma Johnson, who a lot of Johnsons in here this morning, and I don't know why Gwil and them didn't stand. But I remember as a young child, that was a week of work, getting ready for our aunts, uncles. We had to clean the house, clean the church, cook, and everything else. But oh, wanted a glorious day when homecoming came, and they all was here and so happy to greet and see their families. So I bring you greetings on those this morning. Thank you.
Good morning. When I was a boy, Deacon Robert Singleton. Walked down this aisle one morning, and he says, I want to tell you all something today. He said, to get this church going, he says, I had to walk all the way into New Point. I had to walk all the way into New Point to go to work, to get money, to get this church going. He said, Lord, I want you to thank you this morning for support me.
Amen. Again, I say as a homecomer, thank you very much for the wonderful welcome. Thank all of you who contributed with your comments about your elders. Thank you so much. We'll now have announcements from Miss Alberta Jones. There was no institution of higher learning, or learning at all. They made sure that the children of the community had a school. It's called the Rosenwald School. It is and Wales Center, so it's both names are used, but it is originally a Rosenwald School. We have been working on the school, as you know, for a number of years now. And we want to give you an update of what's happening with the school this morning. So Ms. Salenta Johnson will give us that update.
I'm going to greet you for a second. I didn't get up when everybody did because I knew I was getting ready to get up. But I just want to shout out my mother, Rosalind Johnson. Y'all knew her, my grandparents in this church, Violet and Rufus Forrest, and aunts, uncles, got my sister, Cavell, cousins, everybody. But just glad to be here. So as Hollis mentioned, the Antioch Rosenwald School is down here. It's part of our church. It's the only remaining Rosenwald School in the county, and it's the only school that wasn't owned by the county. It is actually privately owned by Antioch Church.
So the project to restore the school, of course, was slowed down as a result of the pandemic, like many other things. But now it's back on track to return the facade of the building and the interior to the original Rosenwald school design. So some of the items that have been completed so far, the windows have been installed. You may have noticed them if you drove by to the original design that was for the Rosenwald school. Cleaning of debris from the gutters, along with minor roof repairs. No, roof repairs are being addressed. There was also a hood vent that's been rebuilt. And the offices of the church and some members of the committee met with the architects to discuss the plans for the building. And the architect has provided several options for replacing the roof, and as well as the interior renovations to restore the building back to the original Rosenwald design. And the most recent thing that we did an exhibit at the Matthews Historical Society Museum, an exhibit display of the school during the 2023 Mayfair this year, Mayfair Festival. And the theme of the Mayfair Festival was education in Matthews. So some of the items are on loan. They're currently on display at the museum. They're on loan, I understand, until the end of the summer, on loan. So we will get them back so that we can have them for when we reopen our museum. Some of the items included some school desks, the old wooden school desks that were with the original school, copies of some school textbooks, and there's also a 19th century adding machine that we loaned them. And FYI, for those of us that are in the, I'd say, over 50 generation, if you want to know where the museum is, it's the old craftsman shop. A few other highlights that were noticed. In touring the building, we discovered that the electrical panel may not need to be upgraded. That's a good thing. There are also some ceramic light fixtures that are in the ceiling that were original to the building, and they can be used when we start the interior renovation. There's also some original wainscoting that can be salvaged. That's also good, too, to keep the historical theme of the building going. It's good that some of the items are still there and are still available that we can use them. And we've also found some more historical data about the school, including the fact that they had a county, the white citizens of the county also participated in the groundbreaking ceremony back around 1927, I think it was. I have the dates, I just can't remember right now. And we also know who the first principal of the school was and the names of some of the principal and some of the teachers when the school opened in around 1927. And we still have some members that were that attended the Antioch School. So the future plans for the museum, we're contacting Fisk University to get copies of the original architect designs of the two teacher classrooms. I know when I was growing up, you remember it was just two rooms. That's how it was with the two classrooms that they had. We're getting estimates from the contractors for the renovations and to include the plumbing, electrical, the roofing, et cetera, an accessible ramp. And what the plans are to return a portion of the building back to the L.W. Wills Center Museum to display the educational artifacts of the Antioch School, Thomas Hunter School, and the historical footprint of African Americans in the Matthews County, so that this is our opportunity for us to tell our history with the truth of our history. Another thing that's future, designation of the Antioch School and Antioch Baptist Church as historical sites. And the insulation of the original windows over at the Rosenwald School was a major criteria to meet Virginia's compliance codes for historical markers. So as we prepare for the future closure of the project, we do thank everyone very much for your prayers and for your support. Thank you.
Thank you, Salenta. As stated, we have a very historical building in our community, and it's up to us as members and friends of the Antioch Baptist Church to make sure that we maintain the building, that we get it back to a state where it can actually be used. So without question, I'm sure the church would love any contributions that you can give us so that the work can continue. We've had some start and stop periods, for me personally, as a member of the church, I would suggest that we all get a little busier as it relates to the Rosenwald School, do something to help move the progress of that restoration forward. As stated by the church clerk with the announcements. There is a program going on that's related to the Fairfield Foundation. The Fairfield Foundation is a 501c organization that actually assists communities and owners with old historic buildings. They find out historical items about the building. They even do architectural work. And I have spoken to one of the owners or founders of that organization, and they have actually agreed to assist us. So I think if we could send a representative to this meeting that's happening in the courthouse soon, I think that would help us let people know that we are here, we are doing the work, and we need assistance. Okay? Thank you so much.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I don't do too much talking because my voice a little tight this morning, but I was listening while I'm sitting here listening to the good things that's going on about homecoming. I used to love homecoming myself. And follow up with homecoming, you always have like a revival coming the week after. So it was a song that was in a revival that I want everybody to take a part in and sing it with me, because it was one of my songs, favorite songs when I was a little girl in the church. So it starts like this. I said that I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I couldn't keep it. Come on. Oh, I
couldn't keep it to myself.
Oh, I
couldn't keep it to myself.
I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I
couldn't keep it to myself.
Oh, what the Lord
has done for me.
Oh, you ought to been there.
You ought to been there.
When he saved my soul.
Saved my soul.
You ought to been there.
You ought to been there.
When he wrote my name on the tell the world. Come on, everybody know this song. I'm saying it again. Oh, I said that I wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I
couldn't keep it to myself.
Oh, I
couldn't keep it to myself.
Oh, wasn't gonna tell nobody, but I
couldn't keep it to myself.
Well, the Lord,
what the Lord has done for me.
Oh, you ought to been there.
You ought to been there.
When he saved my soul. I testify, but I
couldn't keep it to myself.
Oh, I
couldn't keep it to myself.
Oh, I
keep it to myself.
I said that I wasn't gonna testify, but I
this is the day that the Lord has made. We are rejoicing. We're going to be glad in this day. Amen. So, to give honor to God, who is definitely the head of my life, I just want to say welcome to all of you one more time. So, I am here to do the occasion. So, I guess all of us by now, we know why we are here. But anyway, I'm going to tell you a little bit about homecoming in the past. So church homecoming is a celebration of a church beginning. It usually includes two events, preaching and a communal meal. A common practice is to have a former pastor or special guest minister deliver the sermon. Today, we are celebrating 77 years of homecomings at Antioch Baptist Church. Give God praise for that. In 1946, a little before I was born, the ladies of this branch of Zion visited a church homecoming in Gloucester County, enjoyed it, and wanted a homecoming of our own. So aren't we glad that that happened? On August 17, 1947, Antioch Baptist Church members held their very first homecoming. Worship services were held in the morning and afternoon, with an afternoon meal being served in between the two. Do you all remember that? Morning and afternoon all day? No AC. Oh my goodness. We can't stand for a minute without AC. Only fanning with a piece of paper, not even a fan. Food had to be cooked at the ladies' homes and delivered to the church along with the dishes to serve the food on, as we had no dining hall. Did y'all see the dining hall back there today? It looked so beautiful. These people didn't have that. The meal was served as tables placed under the trees for shade. We continued with a morning service and an afternoon service for many years. However, over the years, things changed, and our homecoming weekend now consists of Friday through Sunday activities. And for those of you who came out and were able to be at the picnic and able to be at the gospel sing, we've had a really great celebration and a really great time of fellowship. A gospel concert where we serve the Lord in song is held on Friday night. Saturday is picnic time, where we get to meet, greet, and enjoy each other's company, as well as eat to your heart's content and eat fried fish like we did on yesterday. On Sunday, we get all dressed up, come to church by 11, and receive a message from the Lord, which we're looking for today from this wonderful pastor right here, given by his chosen one. After having our souls filled with the Spirit, we proceed to having our stomach filled with a meal that you'll talk about until next year. That hasn't changed. Amen. Continue to come home for homecoming and teach your children of things we had to go through to make this a reality. Think about that. People had to go through a lot to make things like they are right now. So we kind of take it for granted, but people went through a lot to get us to where we are now. Teach them the joy of knowing you have a home church to return to, even though you have left the county. So y'all remember that. Those of you who are visiting and came out of from another state or another county or wherever you came from, you still have a home church that you can come to. You can always come home to praise the Lord. So I say to you today, praise the Lord. And we are so glad that you all are here. So we want you to praise the Lord. Have a great time in this celebration today. Amen.
Next, we'll have praise dancers Sabrina and Robbie.
I know that it seems sometimes that no matter what you do, or no matter how hard you work, striving to make things better in your life, but for some reason you're not getting nowhere. Well, I want you to turn to the one next to you and tell them,
you tried your way, it didn't work, no. You put him second,
yeah,
and put you first.
Oh, yeah.
You trusted friends, thought they had your back.
Oh,
and every time you turn around, it seems you're under attack, yeah, yeah, yeah. But turn to your neighbor and say,
hey,
see the devil is alive,
hey,
no, I'm not gonna die,
hey,
it's okay to cry,
hey,
cause he's by your side,
hey,
you
gotta stop that hating. I know you don't wanna hear it. Gotta fast and pray and listen to the Spirit, cause He's speaking to your heart right now. Just listen to the Spirit, oh. Hold up. Your job.
Hallelujah.
Your bills are due. And all the people you helped did not want to help you. I talked to my mother.
She said, pray about
it. I talked to my pastor.
She said, pray about it.
But I was so blinded. I wish you would just tell your neighbor, tell them for me. See, the devil is a liar. No, you're not gonna die. It's okay to cry, cause he's by your side. You gotta stop that hating. I know you don't wanna hear it. Gotta fast and pray and listen to the Spirit, y'all. He's speaking to your heart right now. Just listen to the Spirit, oh. Just doing me every day. Guess I was in my own way. But I'm here to tell you, without this face, I'm a major failure. So if you got problems, know that you can't fix it. Just give it to Jesus. How can I get a witness and tell him, say, if the devil is a liar, you gotta listen to the Spirit. Whoa. Yes, he's trying to get your attention right now.
God's trying to tell you something.
I know you got your own plan, but God's got a better one. Oh,
God's trying to tell you something.
Listen.
God's trying to tell you something.
Hey.
God's trying to tell you something.
Listen.
Thank you, Sabrina and Robbie. That was beautiful. Thank you. It's now offering time. I will turn. And he cometh to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him and besought him to touch him. And he told the blind man, and he took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the town. And when he had spit on his eyes and put his hands upon him, he asked him if he saw aught. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking. After that, he put his hands upon his eyes and made him look up, and he was restored and saw every man clearly. And he sent him away to his house, saying, neither go into the town nor tell it to any in the town. Miss Tamika Webb.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I'm just going to make this short, sweet, and simple. I am the baby daughter of Pastor Richard L. Webb. You know all his accolades is written up very beautifully for you all. I'm his baby daughter. This is my mom. Wave your hand, Mom. She's here. The elect lady. This is my daughter Deja, one of the grandchildren, my older sister and my brother, and God's sister. Only thing about it, he has He's married, he has three kids, and he has five grandchildren, and he has one great-grandson that's not listed. His name is Kinston. And so he will preach. He will preach the word as he know it. Amen. He live it. He live the word. He breathe the word. He will give you what God give to him. He will do thus says the Lord. You adhere to him. Give him your amens. Please don't withhold him because he'll keep you until about 6 o'clock. Get with it. Praise the Lord. Have a good time. Antioch, Reverend, I present to you Pastor Richard L. Webb. Pastor Richard L. Webb, you preach the word. Amen.
By the evangelist Skip with an inspiration, we will hear the preach word, the word of the morning from Reverend Richard Webb Sr. Thank you.
Come on, let's clap our hands. Be glorified.
this old church. I stretch my to thee. Any old folks in here know that?
Thank you.
You remember old church, didn't they have all that music? They just come in and amen, and you just start the singing, and everybody that's John, no, the help I know if thou shalt grow thyself from me, oh, where shall I go? No, they had a what a lady old, the lady with the piano. What she had? She didn't. She noticed. See, she done sit down. If she had a desk, da-na-na-na-na, you know. Amen. 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 That was back then, when I was a little boy coming along, you know, amen. And but they got all kind of music now, amen, amen, amen. We first give honor to God, our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ, and to the officers and members of this Brent Zion, and to the homecomers, to this very fine choir, this group, amen, Evangelist Skip with and the inspiration for doing so well in a time like these, amen. Amen. When you got singing in you, when you got God in you, amen, you can do what need to be done. Amen. I remember I used to sing, they didn't have no music. Amen. Amen. It's just song. Amen. But then you heard a little tune from heaven. God gave you a key. And when you got with God and God got with you, that was all of it. Amen. Amen. And give a big hand, a big round of applause to your worship leader this morning. Amen. Done a magnificent job. Amen. Amen. Now, I honor my wife that are with me today. Amen. And my family. Amen. 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 I sat and I pondered and I had one sermon that I was going to do. Then as I sat and I pondered and I looked out, amen, God dotted something else into me. Amen. Amen. And sometimes when you going one way, amen, God have another way. Amen. Amen. But he know how to bring it all together. Amen. 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 We thank God today, and I don't know what time you get out of here. Amen. And I know somebody told me when I was here the last time, we don't hold too long. Amen. Amen. So I don't want to hold you too long. Amen. Amen. But I found out it's all up to you. You hear what my daughter, when she introduced me, and what she said. Amen. If you hold your amens and don't holler at the and won't holler at the boy, we probably get out here about 7 o'clock. So if I stay too long, don't blame me. Blame it on you. Amen. Because I said for what I wanted you to do. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Now, I remember the story, you know, it said, how can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land among strange people. But how can I come to preach when I'm in a strange place, under the strange, unstrange people that none of you I know? Amen. 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 And I care not to know you. Amen. Only thing I want to know that you know Jesus. And if you know Jesus, then we know each other. Amen. Oh, come on, y'all. Come on with me. I'm not going to change color. I was black when I was born. I'm going to be black when I leave here. Amen. Amen. So if you're looking at me thinking I'm looking good, no, the only thing that looks good on me but this robe I have on. And now I'm getting ready to mess things up because I'm getting ready to put on these glasses. Amen. And I ain't trying to put them on to look good or be cute. Amen. But I need to see these words that I'm about, you know, to read to you. Amen. Amen. So I'm putting them on. They might be upside down. You know, don't laugh at me. Amen. Amen. But I'm just putting them on just to see the words that I'm about to read to you. Amen. Amen. Look like to me they ought to lift the pulpit a little bit because I'm tall. This thing is short. I'm going to have to almost get on my knees. Girl. Amen. 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 But today we want to enjoy Jesus. Amen. Amen. But she read the scripture that I want you to hear today, that I want you to keep in mind, and that was from Mark 8, amen. And I'm going to read again before you, amen, if you don't mind. And I'm just going to throw Mark 10, 47 and 48 in. And this ain't going to cause you nothing. Amen. Eternal Father, we thank you today. We ask you for your Holy Spirit. We ask you for a fresh anointing, God, in this house. Only you can do it. And God, give me words and anoint me afresh. Anoint my voice. Open my vocal cord that I may speak your word. I walk by faith and not by sight. I believe that whatever we ask of you to do, you will do it in the time such as it is. Let your Holy Spirit move in this place. Let your spirit move so that somebody will say, I yield, I can't hold out no longer. What must I do to be saved? We ask this in Jesus' name, we pray, amen.
Amen.
From Mark 10, it says, when he had heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out, saying, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. Many charged him that he should hold his peace. But he cried more and a great deal, thou son of David, have mercy on me. The Bible said that this other blind man, same way, he spit on the ground. And when he spit on the ground, his eyes came open. I want to use for a little while to talk with you for a moment, amen, if I can reason with you, amen, out of the word of God. Seeing what God wants us to see. Amen. Amen. Seeing what God wants us to see. Amen. Amen. y'all didn't quite answer me. You didn't quite answer me that. I said, look at your neighbor, look at my eyeball, eyeball to eyeball. You can look at them and you ain't talked about them. Amen. 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 You can look at them if you ain't said anything about them. So neighbor, what we need to see what God want us to see. Amen. 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 Many of us today are living without a vision. Without a revelation from God. I better say that again. Many of us today are living without a vision and without a revelation from God. Don't you know the Bible said without a vision, people perish. Can I get a witness? Can you look at the world today and seeing us that's perishing and our young folks? Amen. Somebody told me, said, I don't even look at television, Reverend. Every time I look at it, it ain't nothing but someone done killed somebody. Some young person done took out another 11 years, a 13-year-old, another person. Amen? Amen. 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 And we are living because we don't have a vision. Y'all not going to help me here. Amen. We seem to look at things from our perspective and from our point of view. But we really need to pray and ask God to give us a revelation. We need to pray, brothers and sisters, that God would open the door of our minds and to receive the minds of God. Help me to preach. We need to pray that our soul will be enlightened by the power of the word of God. For we need to be able to see what God wants us to see. I'm on a talking here now. Y'all with me? Now, if you follow this text here, we find here in the same chapter, Jesus was instructing his disciple about a truth that is about to take place. For the third time, the Lord had instructed his disciples about his coming death. But they had not understood yet. But he tells them he will be crucified in Jerusalem. If you read it, it's there. And we as people would think from telling people three times something they would dread it. Isn't that right? Most psychologists say when you tell a person the third time, most likely he got it. Amen? And most likely we would think this the third announcement would have humbled the 12. But instead, James and John, oh, y'all look at this, and their mother came asking Jesus for the seat on the left and a seat on the right side of the throne. Are you with me here? And they had not learned the lesson that the cross must come before the crown. And the suffering must come before glory. Amen. Everybody want a pie in the sky, but nobody wants to work for it. Can I get a witness?
Jesus wanted them to see exactly what he saw. So he asked them a question. Y'all look at Jesus. Can you drink of the cup that I drink? They answer, yes. Not knowing what the cup Jesus was talking about. Sometimes we speak too fast. You ever seen folks that speak too fast? Amen. Amen. You can say something, they think they already know what you say for what you said. And then they already gave an answer and really don't know what you're talking about. And then when you really tell them, no, I can't do that. No, no. See, you ought to, you know, sometimes just slow down and wait. Amen. So Peter and them and their mother and them, they spoke too fast. Amen. The cup. Is referring to the submission of the Father. And will become sin for us. They was unable to do that. For they was too weak and sinful. And then Jesus moved to the second part of the question. Can you be baptized with the baptism as myself? They answer, yes. Not knowing that Jesus was speaking about his suffering on the cross for the sins of the world. What pride did James and John have, thinking that they could drink of his cup and experience his baptism? Jesus used this embarrassing event as an opportunity to teach his disciples. Once again, the importance of how to humble themselves in the service of the Lord. He wanted them to see that how low is the way to the Father. He wanted them to see how humble is the way to glory. Can I get a witness? Amen. It is not in the high-minded society. It is not the high-minded, but low. It is not the rich, but the poor in spirit heart shall inherit the kingdom of God. Y'all not with me here. Y'all not praying with me here now. Amen, amen, amen. You don't have to be up here. Can I get a witness? Huh? But it's the low mind and the humble folks that are going to inherit the kingdom of God. Jesus is working on them to see things as he would. And I wonder how long before we see things God's way. I wonder sometime how long it's going to take us to see things God's way. I spoke to many people, amen, and all over the land, amen. And everybody have their own perspective of life when you talk with them, amen, amen. But Jesus just was wondering how long that they will see and view things with a spiritual mind instead of the way the world would like to look at things. Amen. And look at people. Amen. He wanted them to take the time to look at it from God's side. Amen. See it way God sees it. Not from the frame of mind of mankind, but from the spiritual mind of God. Amen. Yeah. Notice here, brothers and sisters, now this is a problem with many of us. Many of us who are so-called Christian. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. However, they see things that is always right. You ever been around people? Huh? The only, you know, everything, they got to be right in everything.
You ever been around them kind of folk? No, it might not be down in this area. It's up on my end. Amen. Amen. It ain't in Richmond nowhere. It ain't in New Orleans. But, it's up in North Carolina, further in the south. Amen. Y'all call yourself in the north. Amen. Amen. Help me to preach. Hold it. They always see things. But we need to see what God wants us to see. I better say that again. We need to see what God wants us to. We need to be able to see and understand the picture that God is painting.
Okay.
Jesus was trying to open the eyes of the disciples to show them a better way, and that their thinking was wrong. The mind was set on the right thing, but for the wrong reason. The aim was good. Oh, help me to preach. But the motive was wrong. God wants us to see things with the spiritual eyes of our soul. Can I get a witness? Some folk can have some good intention, but go about things the wrong way.
Amen.
Some things you folk can think they're helping, but they're messing it up all the same time.
Amen.
Y'all not with me here. Huh? And I think we got too many folks in the church. Think they know the way. Think they know what God. But we don't know. Can I get a witness? We need to slow down and see what God is trying to show us. Some folks, you just can't tell nothing. I don't care who you are. You can't just tell them nothing. Amen. Amen. If it ain't that way, it ain't no way. It ain't no way at all. Jesus, first of all, taught his disciples. Y'all help me here. I'm getting out your way, but I want to tell that. I want to paint this today. The principle of thinking on level with the mind. Don't think too high. For the mind can think of places you will never experience. Y'all with me? Am I doing all right? High roads that you'll never travel. High seats that you will never sit in.
All right.
James and John were trying to get in a position, y'all with me now? That had been already assigned by the Father. And Jesus wanted them to clearly and have a clear mind of getting them to see what he wanted them to see on that which day was not necessary. God had already assigned Jesus for the thorn. James and John thought they could get there. Amen. They forgot about who they were. Amen. That way some folks, some folks will elevate themselves in the church.
Amen.
They don't sit in the back no more. Come on up to the front. And some folks ain't deacons and preachers or such, but they sit up in the church, think they are. They elevated themselves in a place that God ain't called them to be. Help me to preach. And some of us think we are leaders, preachers. All of us are leaders in some capacity. Amen. All of us are leaders for the kingdom of God. But God have placed some folk in assignment. And amen. And you need not to step in that assignment where God have placed and called some people to be in. Then you are out of order.
Can I get a witness? But then some folk, they think they've been running the church for so long. Amen. They try to tell the preacher how to preach. Tell him how to live. Can I get a witness? But I thought about it. It bothered me. Huh? Can I say this? And this ain't gonna cause you no, this off the record. It bothered me when you let everybody voice in your ear rather than God. Can I get a witness? Some folk will tell you how to live your life. And that life is all messed up. Y'all not praying with me here. Huh? Some women and men will tell you how to keep your woman and man and keep your marriage and ain't never been married themselves. Oh, y'all not with me here. You even got some women will tell you how to wear your hair, amen, and everything, and not to wear it this way, and go to the store and buy a wig and nails themselves. You got to be careful. Can I get a witness? When you let folks in your ears, folks are talking. Can I get a witness? Some folk will tell you how to live your life. Can I get a witness? You don't, and tell you what kind of car you ought to buy. And got old rag marked themselves. You got to be careful. Can I get a witness? Some folk will tell the pastor how to lead and how and not follow them themselves. You got to be careful. That's what we need to see, what God is asking us to see. Can I get a witness now? James and John. Amen. They wanted to get in a place that had already been appointed. Jesus said, now Jesus want man to see clearly. In this book of Mark, chapter 8, verse 24. And not only verse 24, if you read over further in chapter 8, Jesus, in the book of Mark, Jesus touched the blind man. Then asked him, what do you see? And he said, I see men looking like trees. The correct interpretation of that is this. I see people. They look like trees walking around. Inverting as one more, Jesus put the hands on the blind man's eyes. Then his eyes was open. And his sight was restored. And he asked him again, what do you see?
All right.
He said, I can see everything clear now.
Amen.
But as I ponder today, and I looked at that text many a time, and I wonder what Jesus was asked at. I see men looking like trees. Trees don't have any feeling. A tree don't have a soul. A tree don't have a mind. And a tree don't hate on you. And not only that tree don't do that, but the tree don't speak to you. You could hit that tree with your hand, but the tree is not going to hit back. But one thing, it will hurt you. Can I get a witness? A tree is just a tree. So Jesus told him, to look again. Folks do not look like trees. Can I get a witness? That's why he said, I can see clearly now. I can see the relationship that you want to have and that you want me to have with you and with others. Amen. Can I get a witness?
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
God does not want us to look at others.
That's right.
Through the frogginess of our mind. He does not want us to look at our Christian brothers and sisters from the blind side. Or with a heart of stone. He wants us to see what he is trying to show to us. While we are failing to look. Can I get a witness here? He did not want the blind man to see means. Looking like trees, for means are more important than a tree. Can I get a witness? Man is more important than nature. Yeah, for man is the crown of God's creation.
Right.
Can I get a witness here? Yes. And God wanted him to see how wonderful he had made man from the clay of the earth. Can I get a witness? How he want us to see clearly. How he want us to see spiritually. And matter of fact, I thought I'd tell you this evening, we are made wonderful. Can I get a witness? And the reason why we're made so wonderful, because God has made us. Can I get a witness? I don't care who you are. You are somebody. Yes. I don't care what folks try to put you down. But you are somebody. I don't care what they say about you, how they scandalize your name, but you're still somebody. Can I get a witness? You're wonderful made. Can I get a witness? God breathed the life in you. He put his spirit on the inside of you. So don't go around and hang your head like you ain't nobody. But lift your head up high and keep on walking and tell the world that I am somebody. Can I get a witness there? Yeah. Well, if this so be, you have heard him and have been taught by him and asked the truth. I'm getting ready to go home now. And I'm getting ready to leave you now. But I thought I'd tell you the story before I get out of here. Can I want you to see this picture that we need to see things God's way. Yeah, and that put concern, yeah, for the former conversation of the old man, which is corrupted according to deceitful lust. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Jesus wanted us to see, yes, what he is trying to show us in this life. Can I get a witness? Mark, come here, Mark. Mark immediately described the healing of Barnabas, and which more vocal of the two. Just as he did in the healing of the in the Garden of Gethsemane. Barnabas hit the crowd. Yeah, but he recognized that there was something different in the noise of the crowd. There was something, a different sound, a strange voice that he never heard before. Something was happening, and Barnabas was curious. They want to go and see what was going on. But when Jesus heard that it was, when he heard that it was Jesus, he immediately
cried out, "Have mercy on me." He heard about the miracle of Jesus. Yes, and he discerned to hear more. Yes, he heard how Jesus had opened the eyes. A minute, not only him, he heard about the miracles that Jesus worked it. That's all right, baby. He heard about the years that Jesus unstopped. Can I get a witness? And he heard, I said he heard about Jesus feeding the 5,000. Can I get a witness? And he heard about Jesus raising Lazarus from the grave. Can I get a witness? And I thought I'd stop by to tell you that you got to depend on Jesus. Whatever you need, God got it. Can I get a witness? I said, whatever you need, God got it. Can I get a witness? Whatever you need, God got it. Can I get a witness? If it love, God got it. Yes, if it food on your table, God is able to feed you. I tell you, you got to have faith in God. Faith comes by hearing, hearing the word of God. You walk by faith and not by sight. Faith is impossible to please God without it. Barnabas must have had faith. Can I get a witness? Yes, I said Barnabas must have had faith. He must have depended on the hearing, depending on the hearing, not on the word. Can I get a witness? Yes, Barnabas kept on trying. Help me, Holy Ghost. Thou son of David, have mercy on me. The crowd, yes, wanted him to stop. But Barnabas kept on saying, thou son of David, have mercy on me. Can I get a witness? Here is a man that never seen the beauty of the morning, never seen the sunrise. He never seen or read the word of God. Yes, yes, but the people were not concerned about a blind man. They were only concerned about themselves. Yes, he never seen water, but he looked out here. But when God opened his eyes, can I get a witness? When God opened his eyes, he was able to see the rose garden. He was able to see men's not being trees. He was able to touch his loved one. Ain't God all right? Ain't God all right? Ain't you glad? Ain't you glad that you know Jesus? If you know Jesus, you'll be able to see what he wants you to see and what he wants us to see. That salvation is free. If thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thy heart that God have raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. What he wants you to see, yes, he wants you to see that Friday evening, that Friday when Jesus took your burden in mind and marched the streets of Jerusalem, turned the cross,
turn your burden in mine. He wants us to see that Friday evening when they hung him high and stretched him wide. Can I get a witness? Put thrones on his head, pissed him in his side. He wants us to see that he died. He died. He died on Friday evening. He died until the temple began to rip from top to bottom. He died. He died to dead men. Got up out of the grave and said, surely this must be the Son of God. They took him down, put him in a barren tomb. Early Sunday morning, he got up with all power. That's what he wants us to see. And the last thing he wants us to see, that he's coming back again. He is coming for a church without a spot or rancor. A church that he could present to his Father without blemish. Amen. Stop seeing what you see. Start seeing what God wants you to see. And I hope y'all got that. Amen. Because in my spirit, it's too many of us in here today are trying to do things our way. That's what the Spirit is telling me. And not trying to do it God's way.
Amen.
You can flourish for a while with your way. But sooner or later, you find yourself moving back when you thought you were going forward. You got to do it God way. If it's not God way, it's counterfeit. And it's not going to work. I got some degrees. I don't care how many degrees you have on your wall, how much education you got. Can I get a witness? But Paul said, of all that I have, I count it all doom. I count it to nothing but to win Christ, to be crucified with him and crucified in him. Amen. Antioch. I don't know your situation, and I care not to know your situation, but I say to you, if you know Jesus, you're going the right way. Amen. Look around you when you come to church on Sunday morning, and you know whether you're going the right way. How many young folks you have in this house? Where is our young folks? Amen. They're still in your community. Amen. They're still in your community. Amen. Ain't all of them moved away. Hello, somebody. But do you see what God wants you to see? It's not about you. It's not about me. But it's about Jesus. Amen.
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 Amen. I ain't got to come this way no more. I ain't got to do my pick up my briefcase and leave right today. Amen. But I will not leave you not telling you the truth. Amen.
Amen.
Some of us think that we know it. And don't you know we can be just a loss? Amen. Amen. Because you can influence a few people. You think you got it going on. Don't you know God is looking down on you and telling you you are in worse trouble you ever been before? Amen. When you're not doing it my way, amen. Amen. And let me tell you, as good
as Christian that we want to be and good as folk that we want to be, that don't stop the devil from coming after you. The devil loves to see you looking good and smelling good. He loves to see you put your chest out and think you're somebody. He said, "There he goes, that's my one, that I got them. That's my one right there, but I'm going after them. That's him, that's them," you know. Amen. And then he comes to sift you from top to bottom and show the world who you are. Don't let that happen. Amen. Don't let that happen. Do not let that happen. Amen. Do the right thing. Amen. And your church will prosper. Amen. When you do the right thing. God would add to the church such as it need to be saved. Amen. He will add daily if we continue to break bread from house to house, having fellowship one with another. Amen. I told y'all didn't say amen. I'm still here. Amen. Mama over there was saying it earlier. She was trying to stop me earlier. Amen. 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 But I know all her amen was good. Amen. 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 So therefore, I say unto you, thank you for this day. Thank you for letting me be a part of your 77 years of your homecoming service. If I don't get another year, I thank you for this year that I can say to God, I was a part of one of those homecoming. Amen. And continue to serve this communion. And my prayer for you, what you're trying to do, to the old historic building that you're trying to restore. Amen. My prayer that God will give you strength and give you the avenues and going about getting it done. Walk by faith, it will get done. Amen. Amen. And you wouldn't have to put in a dime. God will pour in what you need to do. Amen. 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 He will pour it in. Amen. Amen. You have so much in your cup will be running over. Amen. You won't have enough wonders to hold the blessing when God started pouring it. When he started pouring it into you. He's going to pour it in. Amen. Can I sing an old song and open the doors of the church? Can I just sing an old song and open the doors of the church? Amen. Will you stand just for a minute, please? Stand for a minute. Amen. This is personal. Amen. This is personal. This is for you. Don't look at nobody else. But ask yourself the question. If God will come today, call you, sing out you from everybody else, would you say within yourself, "Lord, I'm fit, I'm ready to answer to your call. I know if you call me, I'm going to heaven." Just ask yourself that question. Secondly, ask yourself, "God, am I really seeing what you want me to see? I'm looking at things from my own perspective." Pray that prayer. Ask yourself the question and pray that prayer of salvation to God to come into your life. Change you from who you are. Change you to be what he will have you to be. Amen. Are you one that come to church? There's a lot of haters in the church. Yes. Amen. Yes, sit beside you and hate on you.
Yes, sir.
That bothers me when you see church folk hating on each other. Can I get a witness? Amen. 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 Ain't nobody in here is better than the other person. Amen. Can I tell you a story where you're standing? If you're saved, I ain't trying to shame you because the Bible going to shame. God going to shame you. He said, because if you be ashamed to own me before man, when you come to my kingdom, we all going, amen, I'm going to be ashamed to own you for my Father. Amen. This is a good day of homecoming that you can see what God wants you to see after you leave here. Amen. Amen. Some of you done been through something and you didn't get through it by yourself, but God brought you through it. Amen. And you ought not play with him. Amen. Huh? You ought not think he's your homie. He's not your homie. He is your savior. And that's what he is. Amen. Amen. He ain't changing for you, but he will change you. I am God, the Lord thy God. I change not. I am the same as yesterday and tomorrow and forevermore. Amen. 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 That's who he is. That's who he is. Amen. He's not going to let his guard down and when you let your one down. But he's going to pull you through when you let your one down. And he's going to stay with you. Amen. And I'm going to say the last thing and I'm out. Nobody, get this, love you like Jesus. I about to say that again. Y'all didn't quite get to. Y'all didn't quite hear me. Nobody loves you like Jesus. I don't care who your kindred are, who your mother are, who your father, but they don't love you like Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And not only Jesus, but when Jesus came, Jesus laid his life down because he loved us. And ain't nobody loved you than that much. Amen. 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 Nobody loved you that much to go out on a cross to die for you. Nobody loved you that much. Amen. So when you get it figured out, you're going to come to Jesus. And you're going to know that all he's all I need. Amen. 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 May God bless your heart. Nobody didn't raise their hand. Nobody didn't move. Amen. Maybe you want to, you know, rekindle your relationship with God. Maybe you can walk off a little bit. God is still, the Lord is still there, saying, whosoever will, let him come. Down through the years, the Lord been good to me.
Oh, down through the years,
I know
the Lord been good to me.
If you make up your mind, you think of that.
Down through the years, the Lord been good to me.
Have he been real good?
He been better to me than I've been to myself.
Can I say it again?
Down through the years,
I know the Lord been so good to me.
Oh, down through the years, the Lord been good to me. Down through the years, the Lord been good to me.
And he been
better
to me,
than I've been
let
to
me tell you
myself.
One thing, and I'm gonna tell you. Yeah. Let me say this to you. Through this year,
oh, Lord.
I know the Lord
yes, sir.
Been good to me. How many of y'all know it?
But God still,
the Lord been good to me.
I said